Hi, Advisory. It's been a while since we've all seen each other. Some things have changed for at least one of us. Say hi, Nora. But just wanted to let you guys know that I'm thinking about you and that I'm so proud of the young women that you have all become over these past 4 years together. It's been kind of a wild ride. I remember one of you in particular asking at freshman orientation, is advisory for all 4 years? And I had to say, yes, it is for all 4 years. But really, I wouldn't have had it any other way, because it's been such a pleasure to watch you guys grow up and develop into the beautiful and intelligent and confident young women that you are today. So I really don't have any specific advice for you, except please, please, please wear flip-flops in the shower, or else you're gonna get nasty stuff on your feet. So, best of luck. Love all you guys. Come back and visit. Say bye, Nora. You wanna turn around? Yeah, no, she's interested, sorry.
Hi, ladies. In terms of something I always want you to remember, you're always going to hit a point in your life where there's going to be a difficult decision, difficult thing happening, something that you're going to feel like this is just not worth it, it's not enough. And I want you to always remind yourself, it's always worth it. It's always going to be hard work, but in the end, all that hard work does pay off, whether that's school, life, relationships, even something minor. No matter what, doesn't seem worth it, it is. As long as you put in that work, see it pay off.
And Miss Krakalici, we're here to give you some life advice. For those of you guys who don't know, usually at the last town hall of your senior year at Bowles, your advisors give you guys some life advice now that you're leaving us and going out into the real world. So we'd like to keep that tradition alive. Your first piece of advice is that homesickness is very real, but also very temporary. When you go away to college, you're gonna feel so excited, and then all of a sudden you might feel anxious and scared and you wanna go home and you don't know why, because you've been waiting your whole life to have your own life. And why do you feel this way? Just remember, it's completely normal. Everybody else is feeling it too. And about a month into school, you're never gonna wanna leave college, and you're gonna wonder why you ever wanted to go home in the first place.
Your second piece of advice from us is to remember that the difference between success and failure is just getting back up one more time. So with that in mind, be kind to yourself and allow yourself to fail over the next few years, because I think it's when we fail that we learn the most about ourselves and when we have the most time to grow.
Third piece of advice is that you should please learn from me. Do not take morning classes, like a 9 a.m. class, when you're not a morning person, especially if you're going to a small liberal arts college, because your teacher will definitely know who you are, and they will not appreciate running into you at the lunch line when you skip their class for the third time that week.
Your fourth piece of advice from us is to remember four key materials, regardless of if you are living in if you have an in-suite bathroom or community bathroom in college. The four things you need are shower shoes, shower caddy, Clorox wipes, and the fourth is Tilex, T-I-L-E-X. You all need to go buy yourself a bottle of it so that you can spray the shower after you've used it, and you don't have to wipe it down. It cleans itself, and then you don't have to worry about gross, nasty roommates.
The last piece of advice is especially for our advisory. No matter where you go,
and no matter where you end up,
always remember,
we're
your cheerleaders. No matter how goofy we are.
We love you. We're proud of you. Hope to see you soon. Bye.
This is Mr. Castillejos and
Ms. Feigenbaum.
We have some advice for you. Tip number one, study groups. If you want to feel supported, if you want to be held accountable, surround yourself with the right types of students that are going to have the same goals as you academically. Having study groups is what got me through college. So create your study groups right away. Find people that will be good influences on you, and keep them close.
Tip number two, learn to create balance in your life with socializing, fun, work, school. Learn to create that balance.
Tip number three is be willing to try new things. And my favorite way of doing that is with food. And the reason why I think that's important is you're gonna meet a lot of people on campus or at your school that come from a different background. And one of the easiest ways to bond with someone that is different than you is through food. So if you decide to grab a bite to eat with someone and they suggest something that is not familiar to you, don't automatically reject it. Actually give it a try. And that's one of the easiest ways to kind of connect with people that are coming from a different background. And I think that's one of the most valuable things that you can get from college, so take advantage of that. Oh, and me again. Number four, importance of internships. So internships are perhaps as important, if not more important, than your GPA. So if you actually have an internship after your freshman year, then that can set you up for having an even better internship your sophomore year than your junior year, and by the time you're a senior, having internships on your resume is actually a lot more powerful than having a 3.5 GPA, for example. So internships are really a great way to make sure that you have a job after college. So a lot of students aren't willing to put in that time to seek out internships during the school year. So make that a priority.
Tip number five, become comfortable with being uncomfortable. It's when we break out of our comfort zones that we truly discover who we are as people. And tip number six, please keep in touch, especially the cast ballers. You truly do mean the world to us. You've really shaped our teaching careers. It would mean the world to us if you still keep in touch.
Good luck, seniors.
Hi, Few Chillins. I cut my own hair. How's it look? I'm supposed to be giving you guys life advice, which is something I feel like I've been trying to do for the past 3 years. Hopefully some of that stuck. If not, I have dessert for you now. I have three ideas that you can take with you to the next stages of your life. The first thing is to be kind. Be kind to people you know, be kind to people you don't know, be kind to people you like, people you don't like. If you can extend some kindness and compassion, you're gonna find that your problems get solved a lot faster and a lot easier. The second thing is to be brave. Being brave is not always in big moments. Being brave happens in little moments, when you can be the first to volunteer to help somebody. It takes a lot of bravery to say that you're sorry. It takes a lot of bravery to admit a mistake. The third thing is to be graceful and extend grace to others. So extend grace to other people in conversation. Extend grace to other people in their actions. Allow people to apologize and forgive them when they do apologize. These are the three big things that came to my mind. But as I've told you many times before, when people offer you advice or offer you counseling, it's important to listen to it. It's important to think about it, reflect on it. But at the end of the day, you have to make your own decisions. So all the advice that you hear in this video and in other videos and that you'll get, I'm sure, as you go through your graduation and you move into the next part of your life, make sure you listen to it. But make sure at the end of the day you're doing what's best for you and for your loved ones. Take care. If you need anything, you know that I'm here for you. I love you. I miss you. And I'm excited to see what you all do in the next couple of years.
Hey, gentlemen, I hope that you're well, considering the circumstances that we're all dealing with right now. As I've been saying for quite a while, time will pass. Didn't know that it would pass in this manner, but I hope that you're doing well with all things considered. Congratulations on your journey. You got a little bit more to go, so do your best to stay focused, be encouraged, be positive. You're almost there. Take care. Much love. Thank you.
Hey boys, it's your advisor. I just wanted to give a message of advice now that you guys are going to be heading off on your own and graduating. And so I want you to remember three things. Be truthful, be fearless, and be present. And so when it comes to being truthful, that means trusting yourself and trusting your gut. You're feeling it, pursue it. And if you feel fear, move into the fear instead of avoiding it. Be truthful, be true to yourself. And when it comes to being fearless and being present, I want you to think of the Michael Jordan quote, which is, why would I be afraid of a shot I haven't taken yet? And so in this life, take your shots. If you're feeling it in your heart and it's true to you, then go for it, even if you're feeling fear. So don't be afraid to take your shot. Shoot your shot, boys. And I'm really gonna miss you. Please stay in contact and let me know if you ever need anything. I'll be here for you. All right, take care, boys.
Marquez Advisory, what a journey we've had, from the weight room to room 15 to the hallway, and now all of us in our individual homes. Probably not how you wanted to end the year, but regardless of our location, you know I'm always here for you, and here we are continuing on this road to graduation. I'm proud of you guys, I'm proud of the work that you've done, and let's finish strong.
Message now that you're finishing off your senior year and going off to college, it would be this. Don't compare yourself to others. You are about to meet hundreds, if not thousands, of people who come from all different backgrounds. Don't forget how hard you've worked for your success. Don't forget all of the obstacles that you've overcome, because at the end of the day, you have been the driving force behind your success. Sure, you might have had help and guidance from advisors and counselors and teachers, but at the end of the day, you've written your essays, you've submitted your applications, you've served your LaSalle's. So when things get hard in college and you start to doubt yourself, don't forget how far you've already come. Don't forget how strong you are and all the obstacles that you've already overcome, because you can do this. You are capable and you are strong, and there is so much more in store for you if you just hang on and just keep pushing. and to the Mejia Advisory. It has been such an honor to be with you for the last 4 years. I am so proud of you, and I cannot wait to hear about all of the amazing things that you are going to accomplish in college. Don't forget that we are always here for you. Don't forget to reach back out and keep in touch with us, because we are your biggest cheerleaders and we love you so, so much. Congratulations. These 4 years went by so incredibly fast, and I need to let you guys know that you will always hold a special place in my heart. You were the first class that I ever taught, and you made my first year at Bulls and my first year teaching so incredibly special. So thank you for that. If I could give you any advice as you go off to college, I think there's three things I want you to remember. One, continue being the authentic, awesome people that you are. Try new things in college, you know, join the clubs, check out different types of classes, but continue to remain authentic and be yourselves. If something doesn't feel right, you don't have to do it. And lastly, don't be afraid to ask for help. That's one of the biggest things that I wish I had done when I was in college, was getting to know my professors, asking them for help when I was struggling in classes, getting to know my classmates better so I could have study groups, or even asking for help from my friends and family back home when I was going through rough times. So just remember, like, you're not alone. We will always be here for you, and you can always reach out to us. And to my Schwarriers, I'm gonna try really hard not to cry right now, but just remember, I love you so much, and I'm so incredibly proud of every single one of you. You're not going to get rid of Ms. Schwarz that quickly or that easily, so I expect to be able to watch you guys continue to grow over the next 4 years as you go to college. Congratulations. I love you.
Impossibles. Our last 4 years have probably been full of advice, even if you didn't know that. I've given you some, You guys have probably given me a lot more, but I do have some college-related advice for you all, as I think this video is supposed to be all about advice. Unfortunately, I can't give this to you guys in a town hall. Actually, lucky for me, I'd probably cry, so I'm glad I'm not doing that. But I've already talked to you guys specifically about my college experience. You know everything about my freshman year, especially my first semester. Definitely don't repeat the things that I did my first semester of freshman year. You guys all know about that. So I do have some advice to help you not do that. The first thing is to sprinkle your gen ed requirements throughout your 4 years. Don't let anyone tell you to take them all your first year or even your sophomore year. Sprinkle in some classes that you really enjoy, that will really help you get out of bed in the morning and go to that 8 a.m. class if it's something that you're really interested in. Another thing is, after a class, if you have another class in an hour, don't go back to your dorm. Go to the library, go somewhere else quiet to study, get something done in between your classes. I went home and took a nap all the time. Naps are great, but can be really, really addicting. Next thing is, face anything difficult head on. Don't leave them to the last minute. Don't pretend they don't exist. That's what got me into the trouble that I was experiencing my freshman year. The second that you're confused about something, anything, find your professor's office hours, go visit them, get to know them, ask them questions. You guys are all really good at that, and advocating for yourselves and getting to know all of your teachers at Bowles. Do the same thing in college, even if it's a bigger place. Just do it. You will definitely want to do that. Let's see, I took notes so that I didn't forget anything. The freshman organization fair, go to it. Every school has one at the beginning of the year. Even if it feels awkward, even if you have to go by yourself, getting involved in something early will definitely make you feel like college is more of a home to you. Don't not go because you don't have anyone to go with. That my last thing is do things on your own. Figure out who you are, figure out what you like. College is a great place for that. Let me make sure that I got everything. Finally, don't ever forget how hard you guys have already worked and what put you in college. These last 4 years were some of the hardest years you guys have probably ever experienced. Not that college will be any easier, but just know that you've made it through one of the toughest high schools in the city. You guys graduated from one of the hardest high schools. Be proud of that and use that as motivation whenever things get difficult. Last thing to sign off, advising you guys for the last 4 years of your lives and my life has been such an honor, and I can't wait to see where you all go from here. Even if you don't listen to any of these pieces of advice, I know that you will still be great. You guys are very self-sufficient. I don't think that you really even needed me the last 4 years. I love you all. This is not goodbye. I will see you soon.
It's Ms. Strizak. I just wanted to wish everyone a good luck as they head off to college and adulthood and say thank you to everyone I've had the good fortune of working with. You've really brought me a lot of joy over the years. Advice that I would give you as you head off to college is, one, under-promise and over-deliver. Don't overcommit to things and then realize you can't follow through with them. But do your best to push yourself to do as much as possible, because that's really going to leave an impression on people. The other piece of advice that I would give is, don't be afraid to take up space. And that might be in discussion, it might be in social settings, but you are valuable and you deserve to take up space. And to my Strizak Advisory, I just want to say I love you. You've brought me so much joy over these past 4 years. Please stay in touch. Don't forget that I am always here if you ever need anything. I love you. Bye.
Thurbellas especially, I am going to continue the advice giving that Ms. Krakalichi and Ms. Vasquez started because this is a tradition at Bowls and one that I was looking forward to this year. So we're going to continue with it. So the first piece of advice that I have for you is to explore all of your options on campus next year, whether that is getting into a club, getting into sports, going to events, seeing plays that the college puts on, and or like exploring the surrounding area and seeing what that has to offer. Get off campus a little bit, but also get involved in something that you may or may not think that you enjoy, because college is a really great time to learn things about yourself and explore new interests. My second piece of advice is to capitalize on travel abroad opportunities if you're so inclined. I wasn't able to do this during college, and it's one of my biggest regrets because I've heard so many stories from people who had really positive experiences, and it allows you to get out and see the world, often for a fraction of the cost that it would be if you wanted to plan a trip to, say, Europe on your own. So get out there and see what your opportunities are for travel, because the world is a big place and Chicago is only a little part of it. And seeing what the world has to offer is really valuable for perspective. My third piece of advice is to communicate. This is with friends, with family, and with especially your roommates next year. You always want to make sure that you have the lines of communication open, that you're honest and truthful, and really just making sure that you are talking about things that are bothering you and communicating in good ways too. So making sure that you know, or you're telling the people that you love them and that you care about them and appreciate them, because that will go a long way. And finally, my last piece of advice is, and especially for my Thurbellas, remember that the staff at Bowls Prep is always going to be here supporting you in whatever you do. And we love, love, love visits when our alumni come back and tell us all the great things that they're doing in college. So I hope to see all of you next year, as we won't be seeing each other in person this year. But I hope that you come back and share your wisdom and your experiences with future Bowls Prep students and spread the wealth in that way. Thanks, seniors. Love you all. Bye.
everybody. I just want to give the Valence Well Advisor a huge shout out for being close to being done with their 4 years of high school. Each and every one of you guys have worked your butts off. You guys have worked really hard to get as far as you've gotten right now. Although this is not the ideal ending that we had in mind or that we all pictured, I just want you guys to know that your hard work and your pretty much the achievements that you guys have attained to do these 4 years has not been unnoticed. Okay. The amount of growth I've seen from each of you is unreal. Okay. I'm really extremely proud of you guys. I want you guys to understand too that when this is all over, we will find a way to celebrate. Okay. You guys definitely deserve that. As your advisor, there have been many times where I did feel like your dad, because I did see that amount of growth from you guys. You guys have supported each other, you guys love each other, and you guys have definitely shown that there's a strong brotherhood within our advisory. I appreciate you guys. I miss you guys. I love you guys. Hope to see you guys soon.